This specific pair of sunglasses has appeared in so many movies and TV shows that it might as well be called the film industry's favorite eyewear. It's been around since the 1950s, but before it became a cultural icon, the Ray-Ban Wayfarer was on the verge of being discontinued, and the story behind its success starts in 1952. Up until that point, most sunglasses were made with metal frames, so in effort to try something different, Ray-Ban decided to make a pair by using injection molded plastic. The result was a bold, distinctive design that made you stand out, and as such, it quickly became associated as a symbol of rebellion, especially to the young people at the time who were a part of the counterculture. It also made its way to some familiar faces, but by the 1970s it had fallen out of style in favor of the more subtle and elegant frames, and the sales had decreased so much that Ray-Ban was planning to discontinue the model, but little did they know, in the summer of 1980, things were about to change.
We got a full tank of gas, half a pack of cigarettes, it's dark, and we're wearing sunglasses. Hit it!
As a part of their iconic look, the Blues Brothers featured the Wayfarer. They wore it for the entirety of the movie, and the comedy was so successful that it sparked a newfound interest for the sunglasses. In 1981, Ray-Ban sold 18,000 pairs, which was not a lot, but enough to make a difference, and it must have been at that point when someone had a brilliant idea. If this one movie managed to revive the sunglasses, what would happen if we put a lot more sunglasses in a lot more movies? So, in 1982, they signed a $50,000 deal with a company specializing in product placement, and over the following years, their sunglasses would be featured in over 60 movies and TV shows. It was a brilliant strategy, because instead of endorsing a single celebrity or franchise, they essentially associated themselves with the entire industry. They threw a bunch of shots in the dark, and as luck would have it, they didn't have to wait long to hit the bullseye. In 1983, Risky Business came out, and together with launching the career of Tom Cruise, it brought the Wayfarer back to life. Not only does the movie start with the sunglasses, but you can hardly miss them on the poster as well, and considering they're used as a symbol of being cool, it comes as no surprise that the sales skyrocketed to 360,000 pairs. In the following year, Don Johnson wore them in Miami Vice and further pushed the sales to 720,000 pairs, and suddenly, the Wayfarer was relevant again, and this time, it was here to stay. It became a pop culture phenomenon. It was referenced in songs, books, media. It was worn by so many iconic people that it turned into a symbol of being cool. I mean, even the cool emoji wears them, and nowadays, more than half a century later, it can still be seen in a long list of film and TV. As a part of that original deal, they've had success with other models as well, like the Aviator, the Clubmasters, and the Predators. But to a lot of film fans, the Wayfarer remains the undisputed timeless classic.